Hey, what's going on everybody, and welcome back to another VFX tutorial. So in today's video we're going to be creating this Diagon Alley kind of VFX shot, as you can see in the example here. So the first thing we can do is go down to VFX and open up a VFX template. Now in this example we don't need these two windows, so I'm just going to minimize this and then go ahead and load up the movie clip that you want to use. So this is the movie clip that I'm going to be using, and if you want to use this too there will be a link in the description. Now we can set the start and end frame. If you want to use the whole clip, just go over here and set scene frames, then this will just change the timeline to be the length of your movie clip. So what I'm going to do is go to the start frame. Let's start this on frame 77. And now since we offset this by 77 frames, I'm just going to make the end plus 77. Now we have this, we can go over to prefetch. So now this has been prefetched, we can actually play through this and see how it looks. And then one last thing I want to do is go over here to the properties panel and then scroll all the way down to color management. And we just want to change this from filmic back to standard. And again, if you want to use filmic, that's entirely up to you. So the idea is I want to change the colours and maybe add a sign up here to try and change this and make it look as if it comes straight out of Diagon Alley. So the first thing we need to do is go ahead and track this. And even though the camera is moving quite a bit, it should be fairly simple. So let's jump back to the first frame. So over in the tracking settings, let's make this a little bit bigger. We want to change the motion model from location to location, rotation and scale. Now I don't think there is any rotation in this, so we could actually just use location and scale, but I'm going to throw the rotation in just in case. And then here for the match, I'm going to change this to previous frame. And I'm also going to enable normalize, which helps track a little bit better. Then I'm just going to go over here, change this to the tracking tab. And now we can go ahead and add some tracking markers. So I'm just going to zoom in. And then I'm going to hold control and then click. So that's one. I'm going to click over on this corner here. And if you want, you could press G, move this around. Again, control click, add another tracking marker. And then the last one over here. So now we have these four markers, go ahead and press A, select all of them. And then go down here and we want to track this forward. And by the way, if you don't use this template and you don't see these buttons, you can just scroll down here, open this up and you have the same buttons here. So just track this forward, it's entirely up to you. So now that's tracked and it stays in position, we can use this. I'm going to jump back to the first frame. Now over here, we're going to change this from the track tab to the solve tab, though we're not actually going to solve anything, so I'll close this up, don't need it. What we are going to use is this plain track section here. So since we have these four tracking markers selected, we can click this button. And again, we can move this around by pressing G, or scale it down by pressing S. Or if you need to, you can press R to rotate, it's entirely up to you. But we just want to grab these now and place these in the corners. So just click, grab this. And as you can see, I'm kind of leaving a bit of a gap between the actual border and the inside. Now we can get rid of this panel, I'm going to press T. And we can get rid of this one by pressing N. And again, you just want to align this up. So we should have something like this, and if we play through it should stick to that sign and it shouldn't move around. If you find it does move around, then you will need to retrack one of these points. Just go through and find out which one of them is broken and then fix it. So now we have this, we can actually move on to the compositing. So in the compositing section, let's go ahead and check use nodes, and we don't need this render layer, so go ahead and select it and delete it. Then shift A, go to input, add in movie clip. Connect this up to the composite node, and then down here click this movie clip icon, then select your movie clip. And since we have the backdrop enabled, we can control shift and then left click on any node and it will just connect to a viewer node. The background is a little bit too big, I'm just going to click view and then click fit, and there we go. So I'm going to press N, get rid of this, and then just tidy this up. Now I'm just going to jump to the first frame. So now we can composite the 2D plane, so it's pretty simple. We're going to shift A, go to color, add in a mix, just drop this in here, control shift left click, connect the view node, and then shift A, go down to distort, then plane track deform, drop this in here, Now for this node, which by the way is an amazing node, let's go down to this movie clip icon, again select our movie clip, and then here this tracking object, we want to select this and use the camera. Then for the track, we just want to use the plane track that we created, and then now we can just connect this up to the image slot here, and it turns black, which don't worry, that's meant to happen. So we just need to click this button here, which just enables the alpha. So the only place that should now be black is the area that we created, where we could actually use an image, or in fact if you want to use a movie clip you could turn this into a video, but for this example I'm just going to use an image. So Shift A, go to input, add an image, and then connect this up, and then go ahead and open up your image. So this is the image I'm going to be using, and it took me about 5 minutes to make in GIMP. If you want, you can use this, but you'd probably be better off making it yourself and spending a bit more time to make it look better. If you want, you can enable motion blur, so it will simulate motion blur for the edges and the actual image. So if you want to play around with that, go ahead and use that. I'm just going to uncheck this for now. So now we have the sign in the shot. So it doesn't look too great right now. We've got the colors that we need to change, and also we could add some contact shadows. So if we just take our image and just move it back a bit. And in fact, to make things a bit easier, we could plug this into the viewer node. So Control Shift and left click on this node just to plug it into the viewer node. And Shift A, go to color, add in a mix node. I'm going to drop this in here, and Control Shift and left click on this node just to see what's happening. Now we can Shift A, go down to matte, add in a box mask. And then we want to take this mask and plug it into the factor. So this is our box mask here. We can make this bigger. So we just want to fill this up all the way, something like that. And if we take our box mask and duplicate it, so Shift D, and if we take this mask and plug it into here where it says mask, we're going to use this as a garbage mask. So now for this one, we just want to make it smaller, so something like this. And we can't actually see anything, so let's change this mask type from add to not. So now if we go to this mix node and just change this to black, so now we have this black edge which is going to be our shadow. It's a bit too big right now, so I'm going to go back to this box mask and then just increase this. And again, how thick this is will always depend on your scene. Shift A, go to filter, add in a blur node, and then drop this in here. So for the filter type, I'm going to change this to fast Gaussian, and then just increase this to something like 90. There we go. So now we have this nice little shadow around the edge. And then I'm just going to select this node and then press M just to mute it. Then let's go back here and plug this back into the viewer node. So it adds this nice little shadow around the edge. Again, if we turn it off, and then turn it back on. So yeah, now we have this sign in our scene and it looks amazing. Not really, it doesn't, it looks terrible. The colors need changing, and in the actual Harry Potter films the sign starts off black and then the sign just appears. So I kind of want to replicate that, which again is not too difficult. We're just going to add one more node in here. I'm just going to jump back to the first frame, then we can Shift A, go to color, and add in a mix node, drop this in here. Then we can Shift A, go to input, add in a movie clip, maybe just make a bit of space here. So then just go to open, and again if you want to use this asset the link will be in our blog. So now I'm going to connect this image up to the factor, and then what we need to do is just take this out here and plug this into the bottom just to switch these around, and then we can change this color to be black. And there we go. So when we play through this, we can see this sign will now appear. So there's a couple of things that we need to do. First, this black color is far too black, so I'm going to grab this and just drag it up just a little bit. And again, I might come back and change this, but for now that looks okay. So one of the main problems that we have, this movie clip has already started. So what we could do is we delete this and Shift A, go to input and add an image. So now with this image node, we want to go ahead and open up the same movie clip that we just loaded in. So don't worry, I'm not crazy, there is a reason why we did this. So as you can see, the image node has now changed to an image sequence node. We can now plug this back up to the factor. So first off, we need to choose how many frames this video clip has. So let's just say 500. And then for the start frame, we don't want this to be frame 1. We could either have this frame 77, or actually let this play first and then say around frame 100. So then as we play through, this sign should now appear. So we can see that works well. Let's close this down, we don't need it anymore. And now the last thing we can do is play around with the colours. We can see this shot is far too colourful and vibrant. I imagine this to be darker and a bit more gloomier, a bit less saturated. So for colour correction, it usually happens right after the movie clip. And then I'm going to Shift A, go to colour. Then let's use a hue saturation value. Drop this on here. So yeah, let's reduce the saturation a bit. And then also let's make this a little bit darker. Then Shift A, go to colour. Let's add in a colour balance. Drop this in here. So I want the shadows to be kind of a bluish colour. I also want to drag this up just a little bit so it's not as dark. That looks pretty good. If you want, play around with the midtones and the highlights. So what I'm going to do is go back to this sign here. So I'm going to grab this colour balance here, Shift D. Just drop this on like this. So now we can see it blends in a little bit better. And again, if you want, you can play around with these values. And then finally, we can add a bit of colour grading. Again, colour grading is always subjective. What you think looks good, maybe somebody else doesn't. So I would say go with what you think looks good. If somebody else doesn't like it, then that's their problem, I guess. For this, I'm just going to add a mix node. Take this and plug this into the bottom. Then I'm going to Shift A, go to Converter, select RGB to black and white. Drop this in here on the bottom string. And then let's change this from Mix to Soft Light. Now we can see we have this contrasted image, so let's reduce the factor. So one more thing I like to do is add a Filter node. So Shift A, go to Filter, then down to Filter. Drop this in here. And by default we're using Soften, but we want to change this to Sharpen. And straight away we can see it overly sharpens the image. So just reduce this a bit. And again, just tweak it till you get something that looks good. And then I'm going to Shift A, go to Color, Color Balance, drop this in. And play around with the shadows, the midtones, and maybe the highlights as well. And then just play around with it till you get something that you're happy with. So now we just select all of this. We can see the before and after. So I'm going to press M. So this is before, where it's very saturated and bright. And we can see it's completely different. So I'm probably going to play around with this a little bit more until I'm happy with it. But when you are happy with it and you want to render this out, so let's go ahead and change the resolution. Make sure it's the same as the video clip that you're using. So we've already took care of the start and end frame. If you want, you can change the frame rate. But make sure you set the file output. Then we can change the file format. If you want to render this out as an image sequence, you can either use a JPEG, PNG, or any other image. But if you want to render this out as a movie clip, let's change this to FFmpeg video. And then down here for the encoding, we can click this preset and change this to H.264 in MP4 format. So now we can go ahead and render this out. So you can press Ctrl F12, which is the shortcut. Or if you want, you can go to Render, Render Animation. Or if you have the Darkfall VFX Nodes add-on, just go to VFX Nodes, Render Settings, and again, change the settings, and then render the video. So I hope you find this video helpful. If you did, be sure to hit that like button. As always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.